Welcome back for the first part of our lecture, which is on 7.1 on transportation model. Do remember, this model is only used to transport a single commodity. Okay, a single commodity like we shipping a milk from a supplier to the customer. Only involving of one item. Second thing, only involving on the directed arc, or only involving with one route. Okay, so example we have, as I explained before, regarding M times N. N will refer for source and N will refer for destination. Let's say now we have example of, we have two warehouse where we can put as S1, which they have 30 units of items, and they need to shift this item to three customer, which is we call as D1, which D1 only need for the destination one, we need only to produce to give 25 items. D2 need 35 items and D3 needs 40 items. And do remember, when we have a shops, we're not going to get all the things from one shop. We get the same items from other shop who prefer the reasonable price. Let's say now we have S2, which they also have 70 level of inventory. 70 level of inventory where they also can shift to D1, D2 and also D3. Okay, this is example of supply where our end here is the source or the supply, and this is called the destination, where what is our customer demand. And finally, when we bring from a source, it means from a supplier to a destination, definitely we'll have a transport cost, which is we'll call as C11, C12, C13, according like how we can arrange in the metric systems. Okay, so this end source can be the supplier source and end destinations. So this situation, actually we can convert into linear programming model, where our main is we want to minimize our cost. That's why I call here minimize Z, which is depend on the I equals to 1. I means for the supplier, which is I equals to 1, summation of I equals to 1 until N, and next is J equals to 1 until N, where J is considered for destination and I is the considered for source, where we know XIJ and the cost of the unit to ship one item from a source to a destination, where we will have our condition subject to the first one is okay. Let's continue back from this example of the model. We can convert this one into a linear programming model where our minimum Z is the summation of I equals to 1 until N. It means that what is the summation of first supplier until M supplier, and next is we will times with summations of J equals to 1, the destination, how many destinations, until N times of destination. Here